Every wine glass makes a unique sound when we strike it. This sound is composed of more than one frequency. Let's subject glass to different frequency sounds and see how it reacts. As we get closer to the fundamental frequency of the glass, we see the strip of paper start to vibrate. At the fundamental frequency, the sound causes the glass to resonate in its fundamental mode of vibration. The strobe light shows the glass in more detail. Although different parts of the glass move with different amplitudes, they all oscillate with the same frequency. We call this the first normal mode of oscillation. Notice there are four regions, or antinodes, where the vibration amplitude is a maximum. Now let's see if we can excite the second normal mode by playing the next higher resonant frequency of the glass. Again, we use a strip of paper to detect the resonance behavior of the glass. In this mode of oscillation, we can use the strobe light to now see six regions of maximum amplitude. As the amplitude builds up, the motion of the glass exceeds its elastic limit.
All right, good.